my sweetheart. Now you're all buttoned up.
Hurry up, I'll meet the bus.
Oh, my goodness, such a hurry. Give me a kiss, then. Mwah. All right, then.
Hey, come here, come here, come here. I just want you to know something. I love you. Always remember that.
Okay, bye.
Bye. Run along.
What was that all about?
What? I can't say goodbye to my own son.
Of course you can. You just made it sound like you were saying goodbye forever.
Well, I guess I have the feeling that I made up my mind to leave.
But after you stayed last night,
The only reason I stayed last night was because Al was afraid of the thunderstorm. You knew that.
Yes, but I also thought that perhaps after we had that fight...
No, it wasn't a fight. Finally, I opened my eyes and I saw you for what you really are, for what you always have been. There's no reason for me to stay
please
here.
Please, don't throw away everything that we have had over a silly misunderstanding.
Silly misunderstanding? I mean, I sat here in our living room seeing my wife kissing another man on videotape.
I told you. I fainted and Tony picked me up and tried to revive me.
Oh, I know you told me that. And you did a hell of a job reviving each other.
What do I have to do to convince you that nothing else happened between Tony and me?
You know, maybe you're right. Maybe I should be grateful for Tony for just bringing you down to your underwear. Maybe I should thank my lucky stars that I knocked when I did. Because that's the only reason nothing else happened, and you know it!
Alex here, pull up a chair.
I have to break our lunch date.
Why? Ace is working so hard at some corporate takeover, he won't even let you come up for food or
listen,
air.
It's not about...
All right, no, it's okay. We'll have dinner if he'll unchain you from his desk long enough.
This doesn't have anything to do with Asa. It has to do with Porter.
Porter's in jail, Alex.
That's right. I've just received a message that he wants to see me right away.
Hey, Tina, good morning.
What time is it?
About 11 o'clock. Listen, I was just about to pour myself some coffee. I could pour one for you. It's decaf.
No, thanks. I'll just have some orange juice.
Great. No problem. I'll set you up.
No, right. Of course, you don't have to.
All right, look, Tina, what's wrong? Come on, you got this look on your face like there's something you want to say to me, but you don't know how to say it.
Cord, please, we just talked about this. We both agreed that we were going to think about your marriage proposal, right?
Well, I've thought about it.
Well, we've only had like 12 hours since we talked about it last. We've been asleep most of that time. I don't think we'd have many... Oh, no.
Ooh. Tina, what's the matter? Tina, what's wrong?
Here's what to do when you don't find the rainbows in this time. Here's where you go when it looks like the rain won't end. Don't cry. I'll give you tomorrow. Let me be the one to share it with. And each day that follows, 'cause we only have one life to live.
Okay, Tina, you stay here. I'm gonna go call
no,
the hospital.
Don't.
Tina, what are you talking about? You've already had one scare with
no,
a miscarriage.
Really, it's
I'm not
okay.
Tina, come on. I'm not just going to stand here and let you grab your stomach and groan.
I'm not groaning. I was just surprised. I forgot what it felt like.
What felt like?
Getting kicked. The
baby. You mean the baby was kicking you just
yeah,
now?
Yeah, kicked me twice.
Real? Well, here, let me feel.
I think it's too early to feel anything.
Well, wait, was that it?
No.
Is he kicking there?
Of course, I don't think he's going to do it for a while. I mean, it could be hours.
Well, hey, come on, little guy. Why don't you give us a kick? Let me see what you got there.
Cord, stop it.
Stop what?
You're pushing.
Tina, I'm only... Fine, I'm sorry. I didn't mean to push you.
Cord, you weren't pushing me. You're pushing yourself. You're pushing yourself to be some... to be more comfortable than you are.
Tina, I told you yesterday. I got no problem with this.
I know what you told me. I know how you feel. I know you want to do the right thing.
What's wrong with that? What's so bad about that?
Well, it's only wrong if you've got the wrong motives.
Tina, I want to love your child, all right? I want to make sure that your child has got a happy, healthy future. What is wrong with that?
Nothing. Except that I know that you're confused about it deep down inside.
Tina, if I was still confused, I wouldn't have proposed to you. You know
yes,
that?
Yes, you would have, Cord. That's how you are. You're a caretaker.
Oh, please.
And I'm just the opposite. Cord, look, I know. In the past, I know I've done things just to get you to take care of me. I would have jumped at the opportunity for you to take care of me, but I don't want to be like that anymore. I want our relationship to change. I want us to do what's right for both of us. That's why I really think it's important that we think about this proposal. Sweetheart, please say that you understand.
Fine, as long as you understand that I'm not going to take it back.
What?
I'm not going to take back my offer to help you through this pregnancy, Tina. I mean, whether you accept or refuse my proposal, it doesn't have anything to do with it. I will help you through this.
It's really sweet. But I'm not going to hold you to it, because if you decide that you can't bear the thought of doing this with this baby that's not yours, then...
The baby is yours, Tina. That's all I care about. That is all that matters to me. I love you. I will love this child, all right? Ooh.
Did you feel that?
Was it him? Was he kicking again?
Tina, that's wonderful.
Come on, sit down. Alex, check out the specials.
Didn't you hear me?
Yeah, I heard you. Porter wants to see you. So what?
So don't you think I should go see what he has on his mind?
I know what's probably on that man's mind. Something like overthrowing a whole South American drug cartel all by himself. Kidnapping Sarah so we won't testify against Carlo and Johnny. And then he's got the nerve to tell me that her death was an act of God. No, I know what's on that guy's mind. I think he's probably up to something. He's probably setting a trap for you. I don't want you to walk into it.
What kind of a trap could he be setting from a county jail?
The man said that he would rather die than go to prison. So what about that?
I don't think he's going to hang himself today. Bo, listen, I do not really want to see him, but he is going to the federal penitentiary this afternoon.
That's good.
Lisa is going to have to say goodbye to her father.
How's she holding up?
As well as can be expected. I think that this message has something to do with her.
Why? What makes you say that?
I just know how he thinks, that's all. So in case she needs me, I have to be there.
Come on, let's go.
I don't think you should go.
Look, I can be in a room with Porter without going for his throat.
Are you sure?
Yeah, I'm positive. In case I change my mind, you don't stop me until his face turns a bright shade of blue.
Bo, no, I'm serious. I don't...
I'm kidding, okay? Come on, let's go. Come on.
I saw how the two of you were kissing. Don't forget that.
Why do you keep wanting to turn this into something sordid and disgusting?
Hey, I was not about to commit adultery here.
I was not about to commit adultery!
Hey, wait a minute, okay? You go to another man's room. You kiss him. What else would you call it?
Nothing else happened. Doesn't that mean the slightest bit to you?
All I care about right now is to understand what the hell was going on in that heart of yours. What the hell were you doing in his room in the first place?
Oh, Max. God, I've told you. I'm sorry. I should have told you about the second mortgage. I was wrong. I lied. I never should have expected Tony to back up my lie for me.
But he did, didn't you? And if he didn't lie for you, you were going to convince him otherwise by seducing him.
No!
Don't tell me no. I saw the tape. You were seducing an ex-priest into doing exactly what you wanted him to do, just as you were trying to seduce me into forgetting all about this. Now, you know, Carlo Hesser did us a favor. He captured you. Gabrielle Medina, spinning her web.
Stop it. Please stop this.
Now, why was a video camera rolling? What the hell is your connection with Carlo Hesser?
Why do you automatically... automatically think that I'm the connection. Tony was on the tape as well.
Yeah, yeah, but Carl gave me the tape, not Tony. Now, it took me a while here, but after I sifted all through your lies, I remembered the other day at the hotel restaurant when Hesser gave me the tape. He said, don't worry, you know, enjoy, sit down, watch it. Everything will become clear to you. And you stopped it. You said, no, darling, sweetheart, why waste your time? It's going to be just a boring real estate tape. You knew exactly what was on it then, didn't you?
Yes. Yes.
What was going down?
Is that what you think? Carlo was videotaping me to then use it against me, and that I took out a second mortgage in order to pay him off. Is that what you think?
Hey. I don't know what to think about you anymore. Obviously, I'm not going to get the truth out of you.
No, wait, Max, where are you going? Where are you going?
Maybe somebody will tell me the truth around here.
No, don't go, don't go! Max, don't! Carlo, it's Gabrielle. Yes, it is important. I'm sorry. We've got to talk in person, not on the phone. Fine. The park, fine. I'll be there.
Is that the first time the baby has kicked you?
Well, actually, it's the third time. The first two times were about 15 minutes ago, though.
Oh, isn't it the most wonderful feeling?
Yeah.
That's the moment that you really know you have a life inside you. Gosh, I remember the first time Kevin kicked me, I didn't
even
know...
Listen, if you ladies are going to talk shop, I think I better excuse myself.
Well, you know what they say about kitchens and heat and all that?
Well, actually, I need to get to work anyway. Oh. I got the morning off, not the whole day. Listen, I'll talk to you when I get home.
Bye.
Bye.
Well, from the looks of things, it seems you and Cord have taken a giant step toward reconciliation. Have you?
Well, would you say proposing to me again was a giant step?
Oh, Tina. He still wants to marry you? Oh, that's wonderful.
Yeah, too wonderful.
Why? What's the matter? Don't you want to marry him?
No, of course I want to marry him. I can't say yes right now.
Why not?
For a lot of reasons. Cord's really confused right now, and I don't want him to marry me just because he thinks it's the right thing to do.
Is that so bad?
Well, maybe. I don't know. I mean, is bringing Carlo Hesser into this house that bad?
Tina, we have been through all this before when you said you wanted to leave this house.
Well, then you should understand how I feel.
I do. Does Cord?
Well, we discussed it.
And?
And he says he can handle Carlo.
Then why are you turning him down? Wait a minute. I'm going to ask you a question, and I want a very serious answer.
Sure, what?
Are you doing this to protect me?
From what?
From what? From Carlo Hesser. Do you think somehow that Carlo is going to have some effect on my recovery? Because if that's your reason, then you must not do that. You must put your happiness first.
Hey, Max. How are things going between you and Gabrielle?
Now, come on. Fight with me, slime.
I don't want to hurt you, Max.
Now, come on. Hurt me.
Hey, what's going on here?
You've been dying to fight me over Gabrielle since we met.
Max, calm down.
What are you talking about?
You've always wanted my wife, haven't you?
Max, I'm not gonna fight you, okay?
Well, what's the matter, Padre? Afraid of the consequences, huh?
Wait. Someone please tell me
Andy,
what's going on here.
Andy, can you just go over there and let us talk this
out? No, I will not. I want to know why my brother wants to punch you in the face.
Go on, tell her, Padre. Tell why.
I don't think it's necessary to drag her.
What, to tell the truth about you? To destroy her faith in you, too?
Max, would you please tell me what's going on?
The Padre over here has been having an affair with my wife.
What?
Yeah.
It's not true.
How can you say that?
I swear it, Max.
How can you swear? On what? On your broken vows? I swore on the tape. Okay?
What tape?
You and Gabrielle in your bedroom, on your bed, stripped down to her underwear, kissing. How long has this been going on? Pretending to be my friend while sleeping with my wife.
Okay, Max. You're just gonna have to believe me, okay?
No, you tell me the truth, okay? Right now.
This better be important. I have a meeting to get to.
Oh, well, isn't that nice for you? Business as usual. Perhaps I should talk to your associate and let them know how you let down your end of the bargains.
What are you babbling about?
Oh, Carlo, you've really stuck me in it this time.
I am sorry. I have no idea what you're referring to.
I am talking about your second copy of the videotape of me. That's what I'm talking about.
Oh, come now, Gabrielle. You know I would have made a duplicate of it. Just as I know that you made a duplicate of the tape that you gave me.
Yes, but you intentionally left it somewhere where Max could easily find it.
I did not. I left it in my suite at the hotel.
And Max happens to be the manager of the hotel, which you are fully well aware of, that he could use his passkey to get in any time he wants.
Are you telling me that Max entered my suite without my permission and took my copy of the tape? Correct me if I'm wrong, but that is illegal, isn't it?
Oh, I could really do without your not-so-subtle sarcasm.
And I could do without all of this melodrama. Hysterical phone calls, secret meetings in a park, accusations being
Max
hurled my way.
Max has seen the videotape. He is convinced that I am cheating on him. My marriage is in a shambles, but you could care less, couldn't you?
No. There you are wrong, Gabrielle. I could care less. But why bother? You got what you wanted. The original tape of your sordid tryst with an ex-priest, and I got what I wanted. The tape from Tina's tape recorder, which proves Nikki Smith killed my son. That was our deal. We upheld our ends of the bargain, Gabrielle. If you're having trouble with your husband now, well, that's your problem, isn't it?
No, Carlo, wait.
Gabrielle, there is nothing more to discuss.
Oh, but there is. You've got to help me.
No, I don't. But I'm curious just as to how you think I can.
Max thinks that we're connected. That you videotaped me in order to use it against me. You've got, dear God, you've got to tell him that it was Tony that you were doing it to, not me.
That's, asking for a very big favor.
I know it is. But will you do it?
Well, I suppose that would depend on what you're willing to do for me. In return.
Max, look, listen to me. You and Gabrielle, you're my friends. I care a great deal about both of you.
Yeah, you have a funny way of showing it, you know that?
I didn't make love to Gabrielle. All right? She came to my room. She wasn't feeling well, and she fainted. I carried her to my bed. And I kissed her, Max. It was wrong. I'm sorry. But nothing else happened. No, I didn't want to cause you any pain. If I knew that I would, then I wouldn't have even let her into my room in the first place. Max, you're gonna have to believe that.
Well, I can't. Because every time I close my eyes, all I see is you kissing my wife.
Okay, look, I understand how you're feeling. There's nothing more I can say. But there is something I can say to Carlo Hesser.
No. Whoa. Hesser's mine. All mine, okay? Just answer me this. Is there any reason why he would videotape you?
None that I can think of.
No personal vendetta, no scores to settle.
Max, I have nothing to do with that man.
Okay. Well, I'm just gonna have to get the answers from Hesser, won't I?
All right, it's a deal. You tell Max that it was Tony who you were after, not me. And I'll do anything you say.
Anything? I'll have to remember that. For now, I just want you to do a small favor for me.
Name it.
Tina is your friend, or at least so she thinks. That makes you the perfect person to get the information I need.
What information?
I have a feeling Tina's on the verge of making a major change in her life. For instance, she just moved out of Landfair and into her own apartment.
How did you know that?
Oh, purely by accident. Fortunately, it's not too far away. But what happens if she leaves the state or the country? I could lose contact with her or my grandchild forever.
Well, why don't you just get one of your men to keep tabs on her then?
No, I think it would be far more expeditious if you were to play that role.
What? You want me to spy on Tina?
Oh, spy. Gabrielle. It's such a negative word. Just let's say I want you to give me a report on our every move.
That's it. That's the whole favor.
That's it.
I tell you what Tina's up to, and you back up my story to Max about the tape.
That's the deal.
And you won't tell him about the connection between us or the audio tape or this final bargain?
Oh, Max will never hear a word of truth about anything from my lips.
All right, then. We have a deal.
I thought we would. Remember, Tina's every move.
I know we've been on shaky ground this year. But if you make this all work out all right for me, I won't ask for anything else.
When I told Bo that you had wanted to see me, he insisted on coming along. What do you want?
Glad you came, Bo. I know this can't be easy for you.
I'll manage.
I was going to write you a letter, but now that you're here, I'd like to apologize personally. And maybe someday you can see it in your heart to forgive me.
You gotta be kidding me.
What about you, Alex? Do you think you can ever forgive me?
For what?
For shattering the illusion? For destroying your idealism?
I just want to know why you wanted to see me today.
I wanted to thank you for taking care of Lisa.
I'm taking care of Lisa for my own reasons and for her sake, not yours.
I understand, but still, I'd like to offer you this token of gratitude.
Okay, you can give it to her.
I'm not interested in your money. I'm taking care of Lisa because I want to.
Oh, come on, Alex. Where do you think I would find money in a place like this?
You said it was a token of your gratitude. What else could it be?
The only currency I'm carrying these days is information.
Information?
I had my lawyer bring it by this morning. Please, take it. Consider it a debt paid. If you don't mind, like to spend a few minutes alone with my daughter.
Will you be all right? I'll wait for you. Fred, you did shatter my illusions. But some illusions are better off broken.
Max, would you calm down, please?
Yeah, right.
Look, I know you're angry, and I know that you want to hit Carlo. But please, it scares me. He's a very powerful man, and he doesn't play fair. You can't go after him the same way that you went after Tony. You can't.
Give us some space, will you?
Max.
Just do it.
The desk clerk gave me a message that you wanted to see me.
Yeah, you got that right. I want to get firsthand why you've been spying on my wife.
Your wife? I see. Then the missing tape. You're the one who entered my suite and stole it. Too bad. I had no intentions of telling you about it.
Why, is it the deal you struck with her?
Deal?
Yeah, you know, she got something on you, you got something on her. You don't show the tape, so what does Gabrielle not do for you?
I can assure you, Max, your wife and I have not struck any deal, any bargains. She's getting nothing from me, and I want nothing from her.
Mm-hmm. Is that why you're videotaping her?
I didn't videotape anybody.
Oh, really? That cassette just kind of mysteriously showed up in your room?
No. It was given to me.
By who?
By some people who make a fast buck on that sort of thing.
Oh, so now you're telling me somebody else is spying on my wife?
No. They were after Tony. Your wife just happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time.
Nice try, but I don't buy it.
Well, then obviously you've been wasting both our time.
No.
Master.
I want the truth out of you. Okay.
Smart move. By the way, I sincerely hope the Buchanan Palace management will not be persisting in stealing the personal property of their guests.
I wish you had told me about this apartment before you signed the lease.
Well, I told you that I was thinking about it.
I know, but it bothers me to think that you feel you have to move out to keep Carlo off of our doorstep.
Well, it was the only thing that I could think
of. Oh, Tina. Carlo Hesser, yes, is going to be a part of our lives whether you live here or somewhere else.
I know that, Viki, but think about it. Think about him coming here every day to see his grandchild. I couldn't subject my family to that.
Oh, Tina, the thought of you living all alone in an apartment.
Well, I'm still nearby. I had the good sense to know that Carlo would follow me if I moved away from Landview.
Not if he didn't know where you were. Not if you went away with Cord and took CJ.
Yeah, except that we'd have to move really far away. Well, we would, and you wouldn't want that, would you?
No, of course I wouldn't want it. I would miss you very much, but it wouldn't be forever. It would be a temporary arrangement.
How?
I have not figured that out yet. But I know that while you and Cord were away, between the rest of the family and myself, we would figure out some way to get Carlo Hesser out of our lives once and for all.
Tina, Viki, hello.
Hi, Gabrielle. Oh, good morning.
Gabrielle.
So, where are you and Cord off to then?
I'm sorry. I was coming in. I couldn't help but overhear Vicky's suggestion that you should leave town.
Yeah. Although I don't think I'm going to take her advice. Well,
I don't know where Cord and I would go.
I didn't know that you and Cord were back together.
Well, is asking me to marry him again back together?
Oh, my goodness. Did you accept?
Actually, no. I have to think about it a little bit.
Well, it certainly would solve all your problems, especially one in particular.
Gabrielle, I'm not that naive. Cord still has a tough time accepting this baby, and I know that him marrying me isn't going to change that. Then on the other hand, if Cord did adopt the baby, then Carlo wouldn't have a leg to stand on.
Oh, wait a minute. You never told me Cord was going to adopt the baby.
Well, that's what he said, but I don't think that...
Oh, Tina!
What?
Will you stop borrowing trouble? Cord loves you, and he wants to marry you, and he wants to take care of you and your children. Will you stop worrying? Grab this happiness while you can.
I don't think I agree, Viki. Actually, I'm not sure that Tina should rush into anything. No, as a matter of fact, I think you ought to stick to your original plan about moving out into your own apartment, taking it nice and slow, and see how things work out.
Well, I assure you I'm not going to rush into anything anyway. Not as long as Carlo's around.
Good. Well, I just stopped by to see how all of you are getting along and also to see about making a play date for CJ and Al tomorrow afternoon.
Yeah, that's fine.
Terrific. All right, then.
Gabrielle, it is always nice to see you, no matter what your reasons are.
Well, I'd better be going.
Gabrielle, let me walk you out. First, how are you and Max getting along?
Oh, beautifully. Well, we have our problems like every married couple does, but somehow we manage to work them all out.
I know you're hurting, and I'm not going to insult you by trying to paint any silver linings, but you're going to get through this. I know you will.
Oh, yeah. Max Holden, Man of Steel.
So what are you going to do now?
The only thing I can do.
How are you holding up?
Okay.
You don't have to wait with me. I'll wait for Lisa.
No, it's okay. It's okay. I'm fine. I'm real curious what's in that envelope.
I decided to open it when I get home.
Well, Porter says it's information and it's to repay his debt to you.
I don't know why he thinks he owes me anything.
Well, maybe he doesn't understand why you're looking after Lisa.
Well, Fred's not a completely insensitive man. He knows that I was Lisa's age when my father went into the witness protection program. And he knows that I haven't seen him since then. He's bound to understand my affinity toward Lisa and why I'm happy to take care of her since he has to disappear out of her life.
Well, maybe since he's such a sensitive guy, he just wants to thank you. He doesn't really care what your reasons are.
What could be so important? What information could be so important that he would call me down here to give this to me today?
I think there's only one way to find out. Right?
Right.
What is it, Alex? Picture of a nice-looking gentleman in his early 50s, I'd say. Do you know him?
It's a picture of my father.
It's your father.
Doesn't really look like I remember him, though I haven't seen him in 10 years.
It looks like this is a recent picture.
That means my father's still alive.
You sure this is him?
Don't you think I'd know him?
Yes, yeah, of course you would.
Where would Fred get this picture, and why would he give this to me today?
I don't know. Maybe he's written you a note, something to explain all this. Look in the envelope. No, wait. That's
What is it?
It's a line, handwritten. Just says, look for the shadow man. Does that mean anything to you?
No. It sounds like an ad for light bulbs.
It's no brand I've ever heard of.
It's not a brand name, it's a code name.
Does a protection program have code name for witnesses?
Well, they must. And this is the information that Fred wanted to give to me. And this is also the first piece of good information I've had about my father since he disappeared.
Okay. Listen.
Alex. They're taking my father away. Oh, honey. They're really taking him away. Everything is gonna be all right. I promise you. Everything is gonna be all right.
Renee, yeah, hi, it's me. I was wondering if you would still be interested in being my partner for that Lamaze class.
Yeah, it's the day after tomorrow. I know it's the one that Cord signed us up for, but he hasn't mentioned it since he found out about the baby. Yeah, I know. I think his head is telling him to do one thing and his heart is telling him to do another. You know what? I'll fill you in later. Okay, bye.
Hi.
Hi.
I thought you would have gone to work already.
Well, yeah, I was going to, and then I ran across this book that I borrowed from the library. You wouldn't think I was pushing it if I wanted to share it with you, would you?
What is it?
No, it's called The Miracle of Life. It shows a bunch of pictures how, you know, when a child is first conceived and what it's like in the womb and as it's growing. As a matter of fact, I got a picture right here, see? That's probably what your little guy looks like right about now when he starts kicking. And neat.
It's a miracle, isn't it?
Yeah. Yeah, it is. They got some other stuff in here. Look, see? Isn't this amazing?
Wow.
Here, whoa, wait. Look at that.
Please, just give him the message when you see him. Actually, better yet, put it on a note and leave it on his desk. It's imperative that he calls me right away. It's his wife, you idiot. Never mind. Max, I've left messages all over town for you. Where have you been? Oh, couldn't you at least call me? The most important thing is that you're home again. You have to know how much I love you. Nothing in this world would pull me away from you. Not Tony, not another man. What is it?
I just saw Carlo Hesser.
And?
And he told me you weren't the one being videotaped.
That's precisely what I've been telling you, darling, all along.
Yeah, I know. But I got a problem, you see. I don't believe you any more now than I did before.
Why? Carlo just told you.
Carlo Hesser is a liar.
Why would he lie, Max? What has he got to gain?
I guess that answer I'll never find out, will I?
Where are you going? What are you doing?
I'm gonna go upstairs to pack a few things.
Why?
Because I'm leaving you.
No. No.
Please let go of me.
No, I'm not letting go. Please. Not let me explain. I'm begging you.
It's over.
No.
It's over.
It's not.
Just get that through your head.
No.
It's finished between you and me. For good this time.
No, I'm not listening to this. No. No.
The truth has finally come.
No.
You have to face it.
No.
We both do.
No.
Okay? Now, you may not be willing to hear it, but I have no other choice.
Max, I love you. I adore you, and I need you. God knows I need you. That's the truth, please. That's all that matters.
You know, there was a time that all that really mattered to me in my whole life was you and your love. I would have done anything for you. Anything for you. Anything to have your love. But I can't now. It's over. Because I can't afford it. Being with you is like being with an expensive hooker. Sure, it's great while it lasts. But when the morning rolls around, when you wake up, you feel cheap and dirty. And you feel disgusted with yourself. So keep your high-priced love to yourself, okay, Gabrielle? Or better yet, give it to that padre of yours. Because I'm sick and tired of paying for it. Really sick and tired for it. Because I can't afford it anymore.
No!
It costs too damn much. Now let go.
No!
You're only hurting both of us.
No! 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 No!
This is Charles Gibson.
And Joan London.
Tomorrow, the status of the airline industry, according to airline executive Frank Lorenzo.
Also, Paul Hogan and John Travolta tomorrow on Good Morning America.
Frisco stuns Sean and Tiffany when he tells them his marriage to Felicia is over. Stay tuned for General Hospital following an ABC News brief next.